smack it there to get all the powder out. And then we're gonna be like archaeologists in Jurassic Park, and we're gonna go into here. All right, guys, today we're taking the cake out of the printer. We're really taking the parts out of the cake, out of the Lisa Pro. And they've got all kinds of 3D printers for powder bed SLS. Today we're doing nylon, PA12 nylon, PA12 smooth from Sinterit. Now this is the powder handling station. This is what's key if you're doing production with these 3D printers, because this is gonna take all that messy powder that could go into the air and all over your room and everything, and it's actually gonna take it straight down into here with a downdraft, and then it's gonna take that over and into the integrated powder sieve. So this is what's gonna sift all the old powder and refresh it and get it ready to use on your next print. So this is a really key system because it also includes the post-processing of the sandblaster over here. So it's just a nice workflow. You take out your cake, take out your parts, get them all depowdered, start the sieve, and then sandblast them right here. So we're just gonna get right into it. I'm gonna show you what that's like. First thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna press this button once. It's gonna tell me to plug the hose. It's definitely plugged. We're gonna press it again. It says check the powdering container. Everything's secure. Really cool system down here. We'll have another overview, so subscribe if you wanna see that. And when I close the door, it's gonna start the vacuum. And that's what's gonna hold all the powder down. Now right here, we have our cake. This is what contains all the different parts and everything. So I'm gonna come right over this big sift and I'm just gonna open it right up. And we're gonna take this and we're just gonna dump it out. And then we're gonna be like archaeologists in Jurassic Park. And we're gonna go into here and we're gonna just start getting rid of the powder. This is awesome, look at this. Pull this out. Now I can grab my tools, which are just right here, easily accessible, and start brushing the parts away. Before I get into that, let's just get our parts out and start getting that powder down into the machine to start moving into the sieve. I can just sort of move it around. And the parts are fully sintered, so they're fully melted together. They're just as strong as they're gonna be, so unless you have really fine details, you don't really have to worry about breaking your parts. Oh, here's a cool one. Let's check this out. Jay, what have you noticed? What's your favorite thing about SLS printing?
No support. You can print this functional part with absolutely no support.
Oh wow, yeah, look, it's already moving. We didn't even have to sandblast it out, and you have a functional joint. Printed a bunch of these, so we got samples if you're serious and you're interested in this stuff. We sell their full line of 3D scanners and their post-processing equipment all the way up to the industrial level of the NILS 480. So to give you a quick overview, they've got the Lisa Original, which is really just for education. They've got the Lisa Pro, which we have here, and that enables a lot more materials with the nitrogen gas chamber. And then you've got the Lisa X, which is their galvo-based system, and it's 10 times faster. We've got some videos coming out on that really soon. Make sure you stay tuned. And then if you're at the industrial level doing real full production and you want to print for 30 days nonstop, the NILS takes something like 60 kilograms. 60 kilograms of powder, and it runs continuously for a month. That's the goal. It prints the whole batch, and then it takes it out, and it drops it into a cooling bin, and then it starts the next batch fully automatically. Really, really cool stuff. And that'll be available in early 2024. So for now, we've got the Lisa X, the Lisa Pro, and a bunch of these other ones. All right, so we've got most of our parts out. And the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna start depowdering them. Just with the different brushes that we have here, maybe some picks and things like that.
Putting this thing all the way through just to see it. So getting it all in there, nice and clean. And then after this, we're gonna take it over to the sandblaster and then clean up some more. Almost done. Now you wanna take most of the powder out, because when it goes into the sandblaster, it's gonna be mixed with all the abrasive in there. And we'll just kind of cool a little picker and go in there. Take all the powder out.
This one's actually kind of cool because this is actually a three-piece mold. So it's going to secure together like that. It's designed for silicone and secure together like that. So the client, they're basically going to fill this with silicone, and they've got a super smooth, really, really accurate mold of whatever parts they're producing. And this can be reused. So very cool application on that. Just want to basically get in there and get as much of the powder out as you can. like Jay was saying, the more powder that you get off the parts and down into the sieve, the more powder you get to reuse on the next batches. So it's just economical and makes sense to depowder your parts manually. And you know, a good note is this is nylon. There's nylon in clothing, there's nylon in all kinds of stuff, pretty much everywhere. It's not toxic, it's not gonna hurt you. I like to wear gloves because it's just better to wear gloves. You can also do full filtration systems, face masks, things like that. But when you have a really good system like this, it's less necessary. We still do recommend using everything from glasses to a ventilator and gloves and everything like that. But with this particular material, it's not super necessary. Okay, so we're ready to start taking parts over to the sandblaster. So I'm just gonna pick a couple simple ones. This one and this one. So the way this system works is you got two clamps here. Now, we're gonna create a downdraft in here by switching the plug hose on the vacuum and plugging the sandblaster into the vacuum so that it pulls air and you don't get a big dusty mess. But since we're still depowdering, we're gonna skip that step for now. It's not totally necessary. So you got two clips over here. We've got an air compressor hooked up to the back using about 100 PSI or so. I'm gonna take the parts, I'm gonna put them inside. All right, so now I'm in here and I've got two options. I've got my gun, I've got a foot pedal down here. And that's gonna run my two different ones. The gun is obvious, we got a trigger here, and then we've got this small, fine nozzle. The reason they have two nozzles is because some parts are really small and they can be fragile, and this nozzle's a lot less powerful. So you can depowder your fine, detailed parts on that and the rest of them with the big one. So I can just go like this, and look how great that is. Okay guys, so these are the final products. Now, I've got a little bit more cleanup to do because you can see there's still some blasting media. I might want to go in there a little bit more. The sandblasting actually does have an effect on the surface finish. So, if you really want to get into production, then you should consider a larger system that automatically depowders and sandblasts the parts. You can also do other things like vapor smoothing, but for the basic stuff for prototyping, this is as far as we need to go. Now, check this part out. This is solid nylon 12. It's actually really hefty. I can feel it. These parts are super impressive as they come out. And then you can see too, like this, the fine details and the rims and ridges and everything on a part like this. This was gonna be printed at a 45 degree angle like this, whereas this one was printed straight up. Now there's a reason for that, for both cases, but that's a reason that's gonna get in another video, and we're gonna go deeper into how to slice and how to use the actual programs to use these systems for your production or your prototyping. Jay, thank you so much for your help.
Thank you for watching.
You having a good time over there?
Oh, great, it's fun.
It's
so fun,
fun, right? It is, anything with yeah, it's a good time. All right, so if you're interested in getting into SLS or 3D printing in general, or even 3D scanning, we supply a whole range of systems where to help pick the right one for your application. So feel free to hit us up, shoot us an email, give us a call. We're here to help. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment below with what you want to see in the next video. Have a positive rest of your day. I'll see you on the next one.